Welcome, everyone, to University Settlement. My name is Michael Zisser. I'm the Chief Executive Officer of this organization. I had some notes prepared, but I'm ripping them up and just going to say a few quick words, mostly because this is family that's here, and I don't think I need to add a lot. I want to thank you for coming. This is an absolutely extraordinary year for us, those of us who have been invested in early childhood for so long. Many of you know that the first kindergarten in New York State was at this site. We were an original Head Start site. We were original early Head Start site, and we've been doing childcare in one way or another for many years. But now we're together because the folks that we rely on, and here we have Senator Klein and Senator Savino and public advocate Letitia James, who's here, that these are the folks that we rely on to make sure that quality early childhood can be delivered in New York City and throughout the state. And it's just remarkable for us to be in this situation after so many years of being out in the wilderness, in a sense, and finally it's up front and center, and it's just very important. I want to acknowledge, and I think one of the reasons we're probably here, is that for us, early childhood education, quality education, is dependent on families. And our working force and the unions are here today. We have excellent relationships with them. It couldn't be done without a quality group of people working on our behalf. And of course, all our staff and supporters at University Settlement and other not-for-profits. So I want to thank everyone and particularly acknowledge the elected officials who are here with us today. And I know what goes on in Albany. I try to avoid it, but I know what goes on in Albany. And they have just done a spectacular They do too. They've done a spectacular job of representing us and accomplishing what we needed to have accomplished. And those in the city, represented today by Tish James, those in the city who are also very supportive of what has to happen. So thank you for being here. Welcome thank to you. Our home.
Yeah, thank you.
And for those that are not familiar, this place actually was built for University Settlement. And this building opened in 1898, but we started early childhood in 1886 up the block. So thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hello, everybody. I'm State Senator Jeff Klein, and I'm very proud to be here today. And I want to say a very special thank you to Michael, who I learned is one of my former constituents, used to live in Pelham, now Jackson Heights. We're standing here today really as part of history, and a very important part of history, because University Settlement was the site of the first ever kindergarten program in New York City. Which, of course, led to expansion of the program. And today and every day, they do something that's very, very important. They put New York City children first, and I think they deserve a hand for that. You know, one of the things that myself and Senator Savino and other members of the Independent Democratic Conference decided to do this year when we were heading into the budget process is sort of take a step back, see how we can help working families all over the state of New York. We put forth a robust program that we called Affordable New York, which helped families with childcare, helped working families with middle-income housing throughout our city and state, helping senior citizens with the high price of prescription drugs and ever-increasing rents. But really, the major portion of what we try to do is really put children first and really help our young people. One of the things I'm very, very proud of, and I know everyone here in some way or another had to do with it, is universal pre-K. When Mayor de Blasio stated his vision that he wanted to make sure that this September, 54,000 four-year-olds were able to get full-time universal pre-K, the first time in history, we rose to the occasion. And I'm very proud to report that over the next 5 years, we will have $300 million dedicated for the city of New York to make sure every four-year-old in the city of New York gets universal pre-K. But we didn't want to end there, because one of the things we learned in talking to working families all over New York City, all over New York State, is the high cost of childcare. Unfortunately, New York State has the dubious distinction of having the highest child care costs of any state in the United States, $15,000 on average here in New York City, $5,000 to $10,000 a year in upstate New York. That's beyond the reach of most families. And you want to know something? If we're going to make sure that our families, our working families, are going to go out and work, we have to make sure that they can afford child care. That's something that's crucial. So not only what we're doing here today is making sure that our young people have safe and affordable child care, but this is also an economic development tool. If we're going to ask working parents to go out and work, it's up to us in government to make sure they have someone they can leave their children with and be safe and secure. So this is something that's very, very important. So one of the fights that we had, and it was a fight, was to make sure we restored monies that were long taken away in our state budget. Unfortunately, during tough fiscal times, there were those who thought that it was important to balance the backs of our budget on working families. Well, that was wrong. So I'm very proud that myself and my colleague, Senator Savino, were able to increase funding for child care subsidies by $55 million in this year's budget. That means 5,000 working families will finally get the child care subsidies they need so they can afford to work and raise a family. We also restored the proposed cuts to the child care facilitated enrollment program in the amount of $7.3 million. This will make sure that this will make sure that 100,000 children in the city of New York receive dependable, affordable child care. That's something that's important. So I think we made a major statement. We, I think, advocated very strongly for a major priority. And I really want to thank everyone involved, because this was sort of a group effort. 1199, DC 37, people who really understood the importance of getting this done. And I'm proud to be part of this full child care coalition. So thank you all very, very much. I want to say a very special thank you to another young woman, someone who is a true fighter. She has made helping working families really one of her signature issues throughout her career in the city council. Now as our outstanding public advocate, I'd like to introduce public advocate Letitia James.
Thank you, Senator Klein and Senator Savino and Michael and all of you who are here this morning. I particularly want to thank all of the teachers and all of the caretakers and all of those who nurture our children in daycare all throughout and child care all throughout the city of New York. I want to thank the members of 1707, DC 37, the Child Care Coalition, all of you who each and every day wake up and your focus is ensuring that children grow up to reach their full potential, because you recognize the importance of early childhood education. And for that, that's why I continue to raise my voice as a former member of the City Council and now as the public advocate of the City of New York to make sure that we have and we maintain and that we increase quality child care in the City of New York. Thank you for thinking about the least amongst us, and thank you for being angels. And this is an historic day. Families are paying a significant part of their earnings for child care, making child care an increasingly difficult financial burden for working families to bear. The average annual cost for two children, an infant and a four-year-old in a family, cost about $21,000 in New York. And the average annual cost before and after school center-based care for school-aged child cost around $11,000 in New York. And high costs make child care unaffordable for many low-income families. The cost of child care is difficult for families living at the federal poverty level. Families of three in New York living at the poverty level would have to pay almost 58% of their income for full-time care. When you add that plus rent, there's not much left. Employee absenteeism as a result of child care breakdowns costs United States businesses almost $3 billion annually. And many parents have experienced some kind of child care breakdown, resulting in absenteeism, tardiness, and reduced concentration at work. In addition to that, we all know, given the feminization of poverty in our city and our state, it's all tied to the absence of child care in the city of New York. And what we have to do in government is to ensure that we can overcome these burdens and these barriers, and that we can increase all boats and address the issue of the feminization of poverty in our state by successfully securing $55 million. No, I don't think you heard me because you're kind of quiet. There you go. By successfully securing $55 million, the state has ensured continued child care for approximately 100,000 children in the city and opens up more child care slots. For those children without financial assistance, for those families suffering under the weight of poverty. So today we call for a continued increase in child care subsidy slots so even more children can participate in these much needed programs and improve the lives of our children and improve the lives of families in New York. This is a great day for New York, a great day for working families, but most importantly, a great day for children. And now I'm proud to introduce my friend from Staten Island, Senator Savino, who understands firsthand the challenges families face. Senator Savino has dedicated her entire professional life career towards improving the lives of working families. She began her career in public service as a caseworker for New York City Child Welfare Administration, providing direct assistance to abused and neglected children. Without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Senator Savino.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to our great public advocate. It really is a celebration. First of all, Michael, thank you for hosting us here in this historic place. Thank all of you, and of course my colleague, Senator Klein from the IDC, and everyone who's back there. You know, Tish, when she introduced me, she talked about my history, and I'm standing here looking at this room, and it's my history is looking back at me. 15 years ago, I think I was probably the first meetings of the New York Union Child Care Coalition with Debbie King and Moira Dolan and Deborah Williams from Local 371, and I see Yolanda Pumarejo, our vice president, in 1707. And we were talking about issues then, about the need to expand child care, not just for low-wage women, but for all working women, because we understood as union members and union representatives that child care is not a social service issue. It's an economic development issue. It keeps women in the workplace. We began fighting for that then. And there were so many really smart people involved in this, and I looked again at Debbie. It was her idea to create facilitated enrollment. And that program became a fixture in the Senate's budget every year. She was so talented, she actually convinced Joe Bruno, a hardline Republican, to create this program.
Not by myself.
It wasn't easy. But every step of the way, we've had to fight to remind people that child care is important to families all over the state. And during the economic crisis of this last decade, as budget cuts were implemented, it always seemed to fall on the programs that we fought so hard for that we knew kept people in the workplace. Child care, the child care block grant slashed. Facilitated enrollment reduced. No improvements. Here in the city of New York, the previous mayor was closing daycare centers left and right. Those have not yet been reopened. And a demoralized workforce. As we said, we don't have money for the cost of living adjustments for them. We don't have money to negotiate a contract with them. 1707 labored for almost the entire Bloomberg administration without having, with them not having the decency to sit down and negotiate a contract with them. Hopefully that will change now, because we now have a mayor who talks about UPK and makes it sound sexy. So, this is a great day and we should celebrate, but like we like to say in the labor movement, never enough. There are still too many women that don't have access to quality, subsidized, or affordable child care. We need to do more. There are still too many families across this state that struggle to meet those challenges. We need to do more. And now that we have people's attention, just imagine what we can accomplish, Debbie. So congratulations to everybody. This is a great day, but we need to do more.
Thank you very, very much, Senator Savino. I now would like to introduce someone who is no stranger to the important movement of increased child care, the president of Daycare Employees Local 205, member of D.C. 37-1707, Mabel Everett,
Yay.
Everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You know, they usually give me a speech, and they usually get very angry when I don't do it. I'm really very happy to be in this room. I want to thank the senator and Al Savino for being here, and all of us who was in the labor force when I had to get up on that 7 o'clock train going to Albany to see that pre-K be put in place. And we're very happy now to say that it's a universal piece, a New York City piece, that not only upstate but downstate will have it. And we're very happy, and we want to thank you for being here. And thank you, sir, for all our negotiations, and that we will continue to have this. I am really very happy that our families can now go to work and don't have to worry about child care going into different centers or just being out there. And that my grandchildren and great-grandchildren, I don't know, have to babysit, and I will be able to do the labor to see that not only the UPK, but all center-based, all ages will be able to get, and that all our qualified, certified teachers will get the salary and the recognition and the respect that they deserve. And at that point, I'm going to thank you, because we have every people here saying the same thing. So I'm going to thank you.
Thank you so much, Mabel. Next up, I'd like to call up Maura Dolan, who's the Senior Assistant Director of Research and Negotiations at DC 37, AFSCME.
Thank you. I'm here on behalf of our Executive Director, Lillian Roberts, who extends her thanks to Senator Savino and Senator Klein for keeping this program alive. Hundreds of our members have benefited from facilitated enrollment over the years. Some of our parents have actually raised their children using these subsidies, and it has been a tremendous benefit that has enabled them to, as you've heard, be able to go to work, keep their attendance up, and make sure their children are in a safe place. We need to keep the program going. We need to use all the different methods that there are. The pre-K will be a tremendous help to DC 37 members. We have 3,000 members who have children age 3 and 4, so we're expecting to see participation in that. And we want to see other methods, including collective bargaining and additional state funds to provide child care funds. So thank you very much.
Next up, I'd like to call up Deborah King, who's the chair of the New York Union Child Care Coalition, the active members of 1199, DC 37, and IBT 237.
Again, I think a lot has been said, and I want to share and applaud Senator Klein and Senator Savino for really putting this issue on the center where it should really be. I mean, Senator Klein said that child care is the most is expensive in New York State, the most expensive state in the country. I'm the CEO of an 1199 connected organization, and in the last year, I had 6 of my staff have babies. And when they looked for child care in the area of our office, it was $20,000 a year. So what has happened to those 6 employees? 3 of them resigned, and they were 3 really great employees. And 2 went part-time. So I actually experienced the loss of qualified staff. Now, this qualified staff were not income eligible, but they could not afford $20,000 a year. So facilitating enrollment and raising the income eligibility for facilitated enrollment is really important to keep qualified people in the workplace. On the other hand, in 1199, we represent home care workers. And when we had the pilot project from the City Council that Tish was part of, which was just a 2-year project to provide child care benefits, and where there was a study that showed all the things that Tish talked about absenteeism, et cetera, when we had to end that program because it was a pilot, home care workers were coming to me and saying to me, without this program, we a worry that our kids are going to be taken away from us by social services, because the money that we have to pay for childcare is more than we earn as a home care worker. So how can we do it? So imagine someone going to work caring for an elderly person who's worried about the safety of their child being home alone, or worried that they might even lose being able to parent that child. This is totally unacceptable in our society. So I congratulate again Senator Klein and Savino for really bringing this issue centerfold and for helping people to understand it's a low-income issue, it's a middle-income issue, it's a women's issue, it's an economic development issue, it's a children's issue, and it's the kind of thing that we really, really, really have to fight for. And the New York Union Child Care Coalition is committed to work with you in the next session and in years going forward to make sure that we have these changes. Thank you.
Next up, I'd like to call up Wayne Ho, the Chief Program Policy Officer of the Federation of Protestant Welfare Agencies and Steering Committee member of Campaign for Children.
Good morning. I'm excited to be here with our allies and on behalf of the Campaign for Children, which is made up of 150 advocates, providers, organizers who've come together over the last few years to say that we are all dedicated to making sure that we have high quality, safe, affordable childcare programs and after school programs for our children and our young people throughout New York. And we think it's an unprecedented opportunity that we've had now with having $55 million in childcare subsidies, $300 million dedicated to UPK, that this is an opportunity for us to say that we are dedicated to our children, we are dedicated to working families, and this is dedicated funding, the only dedicated funding through New York State for 0 to 4 year olds. And I think that's where all of us have come together, and I want to acknowledge that this was a true collaboration with elected officials, unions, advocates, organizers, providers, workers. But I think most importantly, I want to acknowledge and thank all the families and all the children who came out to all the rallies, who went with us to Albany, who came together and said, shared their own stories and said why it was important for them to have these types of programs. We know that this is one of the most important historical steps, but it's also a starting point for us, and we all look forward to continuing to work together to make sure that we educate as many families as possible about these opportunities, that we make sure to bring in more allies, including the business community, and supporting these programs, that we need to continue minimizing any barriers that exist towards accessing these programs for our vulnerable families and children, and that's why we're excited that this is a good starting point for all of us to continue working together. So thank you again for everyone who's here, and thank you again for everyone who put this together today. Thank you.
And before we move on to our honorees who are standing here, we have one more from the labor movement. The Executive Vice President of the Social Service Employees Union, Local 371, Yolanda Pumarejo.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Senator Savino. Thank you, Senator Klein. And to our public advocate, Letitia James, thank you very much. It is a very exciting time in New York City right now. We are within what I call the greatest time for this city. I am a social worker. On behalf of the social service professionals of SSU Local 371, on behalf of Anthony Wells and the officers and staff, we want to applaud all of you in city and state government these days, because we've had a very difficult time over the last 20 years. Over the last 20 years. And it seems like finally we working people are going to have the opportunity to move forward in this city. So on behalf of all of us, I want to acknowledge Deborah Williams, who's in the room right now, who has been at the forefront for child care in our union, SSU Local 371. So thank you all very much.
Thank you, Yolanda.
Thank you, Yolanda. Again, I want to thank everyone for coming. This was truly a joint effort, something that was very, very important. So now at this time, I'd like to present the coalition with a check. And being that this year we had a $1.2 billion surplus, it won't bounce. So,
it's a lot of scuttle.
55 million. Wow. Thank you.